So today we're going to try to recreate speech bubbles, like the type you see in comic books or just as illustrations in graphic novels. Now they're circle or oval and they're rectangular bubbles, speech bubbles. And we're going to be making rectangular speech bubbles because they work better with typography and they save space as well. And oval or circle bubbles takes a lot of space, and even if you put a little bit of text, they are gigantic at the end. So we're going to be doing rectangular bubbles. Now let's get started. So we have our markup here. We have a container class with a div that contains the class bubbles, that contains the class bubble, and then the class bubble have attached to the div, which in turn have the bubble text wrapper, and we have a paragraph element with the class of bubble text. Now let's make some bubbles. This is the text we want to add into a bubble. So the first thing we want to do is give it some styling. Now I'm going to do bubble class in my CSS, and let's give it a background of primary color. I'm using SCSS. So this is the variable that contains the color. And let's correct here. I'm going to use the correct name for the background color. And let's give it a color of white because black doesn't play well with purple. Okay, now it looks better. And let's give it a border. All right, 1 pixel solid black. Now this is our bubble at the moment. It is not very friendly, user friendly. And its line is way too wide for it to be good to read. Now, let's try to constrain the width of the bubble, because right now it is kind of okay, but if we add more text, it's going to be bad typography. Look at that. We added 3 more paragraphs, and just your eyes will get so tired leaning that big of a line width. So let's constrain the bubble width to, let's do max width, let's do it 50. And over here, the max width, this will depend on your font size and the font, the family or typeface you have chosen. So just run a couple of tests and see if you meet the optimal characters per line. They should be between 50 and 75 for desktop and tablet, and they could be a little bit less on mobile, but I see a lot of sites who don't pay attention on the line widths, and they end up with really bad typography. So, but for us, we're going to choose Roboto typeface, and we're going to play around with the line height until we have it in the correct position. All right, now let's remove. Let's just say that this is our testimonial or speech bubble. Let's pretend someone is talking. Speech bubble, that's what they're used for when someone has speech. So you want to present it in a way that when the user reads it, it says, yeah, I know, they're talking. All right. Now, we see the text way too close to the edges of the container. So let's give it a padding of 20 pixels. And now it looks really, really good at the moment. And now let's try to give some typography to the paragraph. We have our paragraph here that has the class of bubble text. So let's target the class instead. And let's give it a font family of Roboto. This is Google's typeface. If you are ever wondering what typeface you should choose for your site and you aren't typefaces savvy, just choose this one. It's really good, it's universal. I mean, if Google uses it, it must be really good, right? Okay, now let's try to make this more like a rectangle bubble right now. We want to do a border radius of 10 pixels. All right, now it's kind of looking like a bubble, kind of, sort of, but the thing that's going to really make it stand out is a tail. So let's do the tail. For the tail, what we want to do is we want to target the bubble class, and we want to create a pseudo element after. So let's see, our bubble class ends here, so we want to add a pseudo element after, and now let's want to see what it does. All right, so we want to, of course, add a content. Now we want to create a tail, okay? And the tail, what's basically going to be, is a triangle. Now with CSS, you can't really create triangles, but you can hack around them. So basically you create boxes and then you cut them off at the particular angles so that you take away their triangles. So you basically have the boxes corners that you use as triangles. I hope CSS comes up with something better in the future for us to use as triangles, but that's what we're left with. So let's do position relative, and let's do border left 25 pixel solid transparent, border right 10 pixel solid trans. And you can add that code in a mixin, sass mixin, so you don't have to, especially if you're using it a lot. But I am doing this way for readability purposes. Made a mistake here, there is no semicolon after 10 pixels. And let's do solid primary color. Okay, now we have the tail over here, which is the wrong way to have the tail. Now we want to do, we have already position relative, now let's place it where it belongs. We want to do top 100 pixels. We want to, now we have it over here, and it looks pretty good. It is a really nice tail of our bubble, which really gives it the shape that we are looking for, but it's over here on the left and we want it to be in the center. So let's do left 50% and let's do a margin left of minus 25 pixels. And the reason we want to do margin of minus 25 pixels is because we want to offset the border left, which is 25 pixels. So that adding the margin left minus 25 pixels is going to offset this value over here. So it is perfectly in quotation marks in the center, and it looks more like a speech bubble. Like, alrighty, this looks like a pretty good speech bubble to me. Now what we want to do next is let's give it some nice topography. Now what I don't like here is that the line height is way too close together. See, I can almost see the letters on the second line touching the first line. So this is your first indicator for bad topography. If the line height is too narrow, just widen it. Now I'm gonna do line height 1.3. Okay, that looks way better. And always make sure it's not too big either. Like if I do 1.9, it's gonna be way too big. So okay, and the other thing I want to change is I think the characters are too smooshed in together, so I'm going to give a later spacing of 0.5 pixels, just a little bit. But see, it makes a big difference. And those values over here, they should be fluid, so always use fluid topography. I am using this just as an example to show you guys. And that's pretty much it for the bubbles. We have really nice bubble here. Now we can give it some spacing and we can make them responsive. So let's do this. We have the class bubbles. Now let's add another bubble. All right, now they're smooshed together, but we're gonna fix that very soon. Let's target the parent element, which is bubbles. It holds all the bubbles together. So let's do bubbles, and we want to display grid. We want them to be responsive with grid template columns repeat auto fit min max, I want to give it 280 pixels, one fraction of the... All right, they look pretty good now. Now, what this line basically does is repeat as many columns as you can, as long as they are a minimum of 280 pixels. So if they are, see, they're shrinking, but they're larger than 280 pixels. However, if they shrink some more, they can be smaller than 280 pixels, because otherwise they will be like really, really tiny. And these look really nice right now. But see, the problem is they're all connected here at the end, so we want to change that. Let's give it a grid column gap of 30 pixels. And let's give it a grid row gap of 67 pixels, because we want to offset the tail. That's why we're giving it such a large grid row gap. See, if we remove it, the tail is going to be on top of the second bubble, and we don't want that. This is just an example. I mean, it depends on your layout, how you want it to look like. I'm just giving an example and justified center. And there we go. We have really nice speech bubbles. They're responsive, and you can use them for testimonials. You can use them anytime there is a speech coming, or you want to show the reader that someone is talking. They're very rarely utilized in sites, but I think they should be a thing more often. And over here we have the circle bubble. Now let's try to uncomb. Let me show you what the circle bubble is going to look like. This is the circle. It's very funny, but as I said, see, the same amount of text is just so much more space taking. So that's why I prefer the rectangle speech bubbles whenever you want to use them for the web.